You have this great compendium. We were talking during the show of cultures and the clash of cultures and the joy that comes from foods clashing and scents coming together and colors and all that sort of stuff. Is that part of your experience of the UK, that it's a changing place, that there's
Oh, it's
a
a melting
melding?
pot. It always has been. Since before the Middle Ages. And if you think of, the ships going out from London, I mean, an empire was built on the navy and on the exploits of merchant shipping. And people came back. And, there was a real explosion of color, even from about the early, oh, about 1910, when people arrived from what we call Bohemia, from gypsies from Romania. And you know the term Bohemians? That's what it came from, because people started emulating their dress, their flouncy dresses and their big hooped earrings and so on. And of course, in Britain you had an Indian community, you had a West Indian community, you had people from many different cultures living in pockets, particularly around the East End area. So that there was this the real mixing of cultures and so on and so forth. But I had an aha moment, actually. It was last week, and I had never thought of this before when I was being interviewed. It was actually for a newspaper. It was a newspaper interview. And I realized that one of the things that I'm really interested in is what it means to be an outsider. And I couldn't have, I had never realized, although it was staring me in the face, that I write a lot about outsiders. And I could actually look at it all through every single one of my books. I mean, Maisie is in her way an outsider. And in Pardonable Lies, my third novel, there are outsiders. The young man who's gay at a time when, it was so absolutely illegal to be gay. And then I've looked through and I thought, oh my gosh, it's the outsider. And what is interesting is that I'm an outsider. I'm an outsider here.
That's true. You were living in the UK. You grew up there, but you live now in California. Is
But
that?
even as a child, I grew up knowing what it was like to be an outsider because my parents came from London, and yet we were
In
born and
Kent.
raised in Kent in a very rural area. Their accents were different. My accent was a bit different. And so even though we were part of our community, I always understood what it meant to be an outsider. And in those days, you went from village to village and you almost
You were an
needed a
outsider.
visa. You needed a visa. In fact, we used to joke about
Right.
that. I can remember when I was about 15, one of my friends, her brother was dating a girl in a village 10 miles away, and I said, oh, has he got his visa?
Well, except it wasn't funny in
It
some way
was,
in some
no,
ways,
it
right?
was
We understand
outsiders.
that. We understand that.